inducted into the seminar circuit of this country, and I traveled all over the place because of certain qualifications or whatever you can call it. So that is the time I came on the circuit, and I was told by the think tanks like USI, Delhi Policy Group, Vivekananda Foundation, etc., that once you retire, Brigadier, join us as a senior research fellow. And that was an offer which I could have never refused. So sure enough, that happened. 2017, once I hung my uniform, I went there. They said, all right, here's your office. Please start your work. But unfortunately, I said, no, my office has to be in Jammu or Kashmir or Srinagar. They said, that's not possible. I said, whatever research happens about JNK, whatever number of so-called experts that we get over JNK, they are, most of them haven't put their foot on the soil ever. They said, no, how can you say that? They've written 15 books, 20 books, research. I said, 15 books, you give me 10 books from the library, I'll give you 11th in a month's time. Writing a book is not a good thing. But if you really want to know something about a particular place, then you have to ask the local, what is his voice? And unfortunately, most of you would agree with me, 60% of us in JNK have no voice. We have certain politicians, certain people vested interests, people in India, rest of India, maybe Pakistan, maybe elsewhere in the world, and they are the ones who are dictating us. So I thought that giving a voice to the people from Jammu, Kashmir, Ladakh, Gilgit Baltistan, or even POJK was one of the prime agendas we must pursue. So I tried working with a begging bowl, asking for money from everybody, and I got a kick from everywhere. And finally, there was Mr. Shishodia, God bless him. He was the first guy who advised me correctly. He's been an ex-director general of IDSA. So he said, if you go around like this, you'll get nothing. You have to align yourself with somebody's thinking. Then only you will get the requisite money and things and all. I said, that I will not do. And General Jamal is here, who's been my mentor as far as 1947 is concerned. We have researched a lot of untruth issues which have been spoken about us, and we tried correcting them. So I'm making a couple of video series. I've written a lot of articles on that. So that is one purpose this thing was done. So finally, we did about, 12 webinars from this platform. But this is the first time we are doing a seminar offline and with you all in front of me, everybody from Jammu mostly. So that is a great day for me. And not only that, I went through a lot of obstacles, if I may say, to be here this evening and talking to you. But I said, no, this day is non-negotiable. Because this day is my dad's 89th birthday. And my approach was, since I meet Maharaj Sahib, Dr. Karan Singh, very often, his birthday is also today. So I told him, you have to inaugurate my website on this day. So that is why this day was non-negotiable. But unfortunately, I think Modi Sahib is, Prime Minister Modi, is unveiling a book with him right now. So he is not joining us online. So I said, doesn't matter, we'll still go ahead with this. So that is the importance of this day. So I thought we will first inaugurate the website, and I would try and remember my dad. And may I request my co-convener, Varun Bansali, he would take you through the motions of my website we created, and I will request our chief guest, Mr. Bakaya, to kindly inaugurate it. Varun, please take over.
Everything in this website says a lot about Jammu and Kashmir. And when you take over the mouse, it is a very good animation right here. You can see all these things.
Congratulate International Institute of Jammu Kashmir Studies and Analysis, and in particular, Brigadier Dr. Vijay Sagar Dhirman, on taking this initiative all the time to bring forward things that really matter to the issue of Jammu Kashmir, especially when it comes to bilateral relations between India and Pakistan.
He's going to take this narrative out to the world. And for this, I wish them all the best.
So good to see that we've finally done something with knowledge. We're trying to encourage people to pursue knowledge with the foundation of this institution. And hopefully in this age of excess information or misinformation.
When we were traveling throughout JNK and figuring it out, why some of the projects took longer than what normally even government projects take and delayed projects take. Our finding was that the CEO, this directly related to terrorism.
How can we sort of leverage it in the international forum? Also, can we use it as a some kind of a weapon against terrorism by Pakistan? Over to you, Professor Dipankar.
I think there's so much information in this seminar which enables us to work within the system to the benefit of both countries without taking certain steps which would unnecessarily undermine our standing in the Committee of Nations.
Ladies and gentlemen, it was in December 2018. I was attending a seminar in Manekshaw Center, Delhi. There also the similar thing, you know, talking about the information warfare, psychological warfare, which is the mainstay of Pakistan and China today, and the ISI spending lots of money on it. And I don't know for what reason Indian government hasn't woken up to it as yet, the way it should have. You know, in fact, there I made a statement, though I'm a defense services guy and I should not be making the statement, but yet to drive the point home, I had to say, ladies and gentlemen, please buy one Rafale less. You will save 1600 crores. 1600 crores would give you a series of media labs to use media information warfare, psychological warfare against Pakistan on myriad issues, variety of issues. Interwater treaty happens to be one. And now today, I'm grateful to Professor Dipankar. I think he's proved to you guys that is the power of the society in the country. And with the help of social media, you can always go ahead. Rather than mocking at the guys who are sticking to the social media, we should tell them, okay, don't see TikTok, don't see movies. Try and do something which is more constructive for the nation and be a positive contributor. Thank you very much, sir. You gave us a great insight. Well, having said that, I have a great pleasure in announcing today that today a great journalist, an intellectual, who was away from us for the last 8 years, makes a beginning again after almost 8 years. And I have a great friend of mine, Sun Sharma ji, who agreed to come on the stage. I said 15 minutes for each speaker. He said, "Nahin, panch." I said, "All right, I want to see you there on the stage, even if it is for 5 minutes. All yours, sir."
Something that they proposed in Pakistan proper, and the easiest way for them, which is a low cost or zero cost option for them, is to permit travel in JNK, and they are good at it. Can we do it? He referred to the Sindh thing, that there is simmering discontent between Sindh and Punjab. Can we invest in that? Can we pop it up? Why not? Give me one reason why we should not. If they behave and they say that JNK is not yours, JNK belongs to us. We say, Sindh is yours, Punjab is yours, rakho. But they should always be at loggerheads and saying what we are doing in Balochistan, started saying about Balochistan that yes, there is a problem there. Similarly, we should also start saying and stand by, yes, we are supporting them morally, we are supporting them every way, and that is why the Sindhu Desh thing, they should be popular. Thank you.
Well, you would all agree with me, what you just heard was an unfathomable reservoir of knowledge and absolute unique and objective analysis. Your parents after a long time, sir, but wonderful job you've done, and I'm really grateful.
Thank you.
And now, whatever you heard from Sanjkumar ji, kindly take it forward, be ready, especially the guys from Jammu. Maybe some good words you got to hear. Sir, is it called summer apples? Summer apples? Have you ever heard of something called summer apples? Sweeter than Kashmir?
Summer apples.
Garmiyon ke sev. Kashmir is a badhiya quality. When it has been done, this is not a dreaming situation. It has been done. And all those of you interested, sir, you got the samples here. But yesterday he said, okay, that will be available to you. So now let's listen to a voice which is probably the oldest, most experienced, and you know, who have been here ever since this particular problems we're talking about were framed, you know, they came into being. So I now request Major General Govardhan Singh Jamwal, who has really done a lot of research, who's privy to a lot of happenings, and just look at his vision. This so-called Kandi areas, Banjar area, is going to be a basket of horticulture. It's going to be a fruit basket for all of us. And it is not something which is just a hypothesis. It's already been done. Technology demonstration has already been done. So now I would request General Jamwal to give you the details of all that what I was spoken about.
So let me start first thanking and congratulating Vijay for starting this seminar here and educating us also. Generally we complain that nobody hears us. We always complain, Dogras, Jammu people, nobody listens to us. Yes. Why should they listen to you? Because you don't speak. You don't take part in any discussion. Only I find my young officer G.D. Bakshi with a good mustache from Delhi. But one is not enough. And we only curse each other. Never speak. Why? Because we don't know the facts. We don't study the facts. We don't take part in anything like this. You're very shy. With the result, others who speak, they take it. That is politics. And what is politics? What Goebbels said, 90 times lies becomes truth. So, what we have been fed, what I have seen as a general of the army, there is so much truth, untruth in our history. In all the battles we have fought, starting from the JNK operations, total untruth. The facts are different. And nobody objects. We have suffered. Suffering, we'll continue suffering. That's what is happening in the fields, what Professor Conker has said, or what you have heard from this side, the water distribution. The British have been totally against the Jammu and Kashmir. I won't say India, but Jammu and Kashmir people. Why? You all know, if you study the history. Therefore, we got nothing what we deserved. Water is only one indication. You know how much water goes to Pakistan. And may I tell you, if Pakistan was in our place, in the Upper Riparian, the treaty would have failed immediately. They would have stopped your water down the road. But we didn't do it. And we are suffering from that. What they have done, they have taken away Gilgit, Baltistan without attacking us. There was never any attack. That force was my force, my unit. They raised a flag, they said we want to join Pakistan, and they went to Pakistan. Because the British were with them. The most treacherous nation in the world is British people. who have ruined us, this country, India, and the whole thing is because of Gilgit. Whole thing is because of Baltistan. And all these things what you're facing today in the economic field or anything, or industry, tea, or whatever it is all following from that big game, because they are still fighting that big game. And that big game will never finish and we will be pawned in that. Having said that, let me come down to Jammu. What have you got in Jammu from wherever? Leave aside the JMTT, the industry team. What have you got? Tell me. Think about your project. Any project you talk, all these things will be manifested ultimately what you are talking about. So firstly, I would say, let us study. Let us rise, let us get up, let us hold such seminar. And I am grateful to Vijay that he has given us the platform. But you will see very soon this audience will start thinning out. Not only today, even later on. I have seen many attempts being done. You fix a chair and after a few days even chair is lost. Nobody. I think, what can we do? Thank God, the social media is, thank God. And the Voice of Dogra, and the Dogra, you can say the cuisine, thank God, some dances, some videos are coming. Let's hope that we ultimately use that media to voice our concerns. I'll tell you why I am saying this. And if you are with me, you must take a vote today that we must take part in all these activities. I was born in a small village called Suchani, where I've got a central university now. There was no water in my village. And by April end, first week of May, the pond also dried up. With the result, we had no road, no school, no hospital, no dispensary, no power. There was nothing in my village. No connection. Let me survive with the rainfall, only rainfall. And that, of course, was enough. But there was no technology available at that time. We could not stop that water. Within 2 hours, my water from my village went across Pakistan water. But there was some groundwater, but too deep behind. We didn't have the technology to get the water from 600 to 800 feet. But now we had that technology, we started doing that. We went up to 800, 900 feet. The water is gone further down. Even with technology, we are finding it difficult to get that water. On the other hand, the water which we were getting 140 centimeter climate change, you don't get rain when you want it. And you get rain when you don't want it. And you have no arrangements to store water and use it when you want it. Leave aside the Indus Water Treaty and what not. 85% goes to Pakistan, 15%. Where is your 15%? I don't see even that. The most affected area, the Shwaliks, from Ravi to Rajouri, 200 odd kilometers by 40 kilometers. The best area, the best manpower in the world, one of the best soldiers in the world. In fact, the best soldier in the world, Dogra, is this Duigavka, the Mansur, Sumisar. That means Samba district, Jammu district, up to Rajouri. But they have no water. They retire now, my young people, 35, 40. They have lands, but no water. We had a very big discussion one day, and the ministers were there. Dr. Jitendra Singh was sitting there, and I suggested them something which I am going to talk to you. From there something happened, but it's not being followed up. I told them, in fact there was also a very big seminar, the international seminar, all the people from Germany, Australia, Canada, the intellectuals who buy the herbs which we produce in Jammu, they were sitting there, and their director, a very intelligent industrialist, Ram, he's gone now. He asked me, tell them what once you told me something about the country and the problems of the country. I said, I'm a soldier, I hardly know much about this. But I had given him some ideas that I had done something on the ground, which I told them, I'll share with you, so that you get also, I hope, motivated. When the Prajapatisthan movement took place, I was a young lieutenant, and I know why my own family was involved there. And they were sent to Banihal, one Karlan Sahib, one Subedar Sahib, another, all my relations. They were put for 1 year in that snow area in the winter. Why? So that they don't speak up against the big landed or land evolution acts and this and that, and they keep quiet. Perhaps they were suppressed, the times were against us, Kashmiris were against us, Abdullah was against us, Nehru was against us, everybody was against us. Yet of course it took a long time for Prajapatisthan to come up, but I wrote a paper at that time, what's wrong, what's happening, and I felt as a young officer, as a lieutenant with 24 years service, I drew up a map how we can live in the independent India. And when I became a brigade commander here as the officer in BOC, I took an aircraft, an engineer, and I surveyed the Shivaliks, and with his help I drew up a final draft, final plan, what can be done for the Shivaliks. And that I gave to Dr. Karan Singh when he went as a minister. He was so happy, he put it up in the cabinet. And it was discussed in the cabinet. I don't know, Bagaya Sahib would probably, he was a young, much younger at that time, perhaps, when this happened. They accepted the plan and made the Ravi Kavi Canal on my map. From that, I put a three-tier system in that. The main canal, 5 barrages on the Uj, Bay, Tarna, this Basantar, and the Devak. 5 barrages at a certain height, they will have the cool system. From there, the water will be lifted with the electricity from Salal. Salal will be a hydro project. I wrote this honestly, I've got the paper with me. I wrote when I was 24 years old. And this was adopted. As a result of this, Salal was already somewhere, but it came up also. But only one pool came, one canal came, second didn't come. The third was with that electricity, we pumped the water on all heights and have the horticulture on all the hills with that water, minimum water use. What later on came as the drip system, but ours was a pump the water on top and use it. Excellent areas for fruit growing, horticulture, even medicinal plants. Nothing happened. This only one canal came, and of course then they started.
Janjawal, I'm sure has pepped you up and made your minds, put them into a gear where you started thinking. And of course, I am there with him and in front of you. Next time, if I again request you to come for a seminar, please do turn up. even if it takes 2 hours. I'm sure if you watch a movie for 3 hours, we don't mind sitting. But I'm sure seminar you can always do that. Anyway, that was in a lighter way. So thank you very much, sir. We really delighted, and I'm sure we would take your legacy forward. Now, because of the paucity of time, though I'm getting signals from all over, you're both there, Ravi. I think we'll take two questions. If there be volunteers with questions, please. Yes, sir. And one from Mr. Pradeep Datta. And sir, Mr. K.B. Jindal, sir.
Do something, yourself. Do something for your own land, your own people, on your own martyrs, on those who have laid down their lives here. Remember them. Jadar Jawar is an embodiment of all those things. And he is a great monitor to all of us. Please follow them. And please look for Jammu. Look for new things. Don't get to fall prey to those slogans and other things. Do something practical for Jammu and people of Jammu. That's all I have to add it here.
Thank you very much for your insight. And I think you complimented what Govardhan Singh Jamal has just now said. And all of us, the younger lot, well, we are still young. So what if we becoming senior citizens? About to become, but we are still young. I'm sure we'll take a cue from it. Now, a question from Mr. Pradeep Datta, please.
I fail to understand one thing, because when a treaty is signed, that's always signed between the two countries. I fail to understand, even after 7 decades, Kashmir continues to be a dispute. Why India was not at that time able to convince that when you are signing a treaty that's between the two countries, how come Kashmir be a dispute? Because Kashmir was part of India. So why that thing did not happen? Because I think nobody has been in all the writings. I read about the Foresight Group also, I read about every other person writing about Indus Water Treaty. But nobody is talking about this point, because treaty is signed between two countries. It was not signed between Jammu and Kashmir and Pakistan.
Oh, absolutely true what you say. That is the case. And ladies and gentlemen, I think we had a very informative seminar. Now, before I request the chair to give the concluding remarks, I would request Brigadier Kakade to give us a message that he's brought from the Army Commander, GOCNC, Western Command, under whom this particular area comes. And the area we are discussing is in the jurisdiction of that particular Army Commander. So may I request Brigadier Kakade, please?
Good evening, everyone. I am Brigadier Anil Kakade, and I am representing the GOCNC Western Command. At the outset, sir, thank you very much for giving us an opportunity to be here. As a student of military history, I must say that it has been quite an education listening to the eminent speakers and understanding the dynamics of the Indus Water Treaty. And it's a great initiative taken by Brigadier Vijay Sagar, the strategy culture, or to have this kind of intellectual academic discussions on varied subjects of strategic importance, particularly with respect to J&K. I think this should have happened long time back, but it's never too late.
I'm sure you'll send a report of what has happened today evening to Chandigarh, though I think you're still in Kevadia. I'm sure you will mention some good words about me. He happens to be my prospect, squadron type, company type. So 4 years of jostling together, shoulder to shoulder with him. Thank you very much. Now may I request the chair to kindly give the concluding remarks. Mr. Pakaya, please.
That whenever there is saber rattling, which was done after the Udi attack and after the Pulwama attack, that will stop water to Pakistan and pressure it to solve Kashmir. That didn't ever happen. And as Dipankar said, that's because we are a responsible country and we are internationally very sensitive to all the nuances.
Thank you very much, sir. You've really summed it up very well, and we're taking home lots of points which have been there. Now, we've done a bit of a serious discussion, talked about strategy, talked about horticulture, talked about Pakistan, China and whatnot. Now, to be on the lighter side, well, I have a very renowned personality, cultural ambassador, Kamala Aunty here. Can I please request you to come and give us a poem? Vivekji, can I request you to come here?
Jang jitya ve mahi mera, तिन मेरा जिला सफल हो गया, तिन मेरा जिला सफल हो गया। चना तुसी जदों घर आओ, चना तुसी जदों घर आओ, जंग जित कर आओ। एक सुपना है मेरा, एक सुपना है मेरा, एक वीरता का चक्र ले आना। मेरा जिला सफल हो गया, मेरा जिला सफल हो गया, मेरा जिला सफल।